This Black Friday kicks off that holiday shopping season, but with this economy, how much are you prepared to spend and how much money can you save? All new at 6 o'clock, KXAN's David Scott begins a three-part report on shopping survival. Tell us how it's done, David.
Well, Leslie, I tell you, merchants are very hopeful this shopping season. Black Friday morning, this Target store will be open at 4 a.m., expecting a lot of business. And that means that the employees are going to be staying after work late tonight, stocking up on all those shelf displays of all their sales products. They're hoping for the best, but they know that with this bad economy, folks are looking for ways to save money. And I've got some suggestions for you. 135 million Americans will go shopping this Black Friday. It is the second biggest retail day of the year, next to the Saturday before Christmas. Some stores will open up at midnight, and folks will be waiting in line. It has merchants drooling.
Black Friday is very significant because to the general public, that's kind of the official starting line for everybody to come out and get their shopping done.
We are very excited waiting for Black Friday. You know, every year that we have great expectations about the day, and people are waiting for that day.
It's one of the times in the year that us merchants actually get into the black, which is a retail term we use to actually count profit.
Those profits come from you and me, opening our wallets, purses, checkbooks, and credit cards. Discretionary spending. Want some advice?
Set a budget. Make sure that you have an idea in mind of how much you're going to spend, because sometimes it's very easy to way overspend, and then you really don't realize how much you've spent until you get that final credit card bill.
So do folks plan, organize, and discipline themselves to a budget limit? Do you set a budget, a limit for yourself?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I'm going to try to save a couple of money.
No.
Why don't you set a budget?
Because I plan all year to shop, and I shop all year long. No budget is necessary.
Before, I didn't set a budget, and I spent way too much, and find out at the end of the year that you spent too much, so I'm definitely setting a budget.
You don't want to overspend, and with the economic times being the way they are, you want to cut down a little.
Some folks dread shopping. Others revel in it, popping into one store after another. Is there a method to the madness? Here's another way to save money.
Make sure that you have a shopping list. That really can help you keep on track, make sure that you have a focus of what you need to get, and avoid buying things that you really don't need.
So do folks make a list or give in to the devilish temptation of impulse shopping?
No, with a list. I have to make a list first.
Do you operate off a shopping list or do you buy an impulse?
Impulse. Yeah. Yeah, but I keep track of how much I'm spending.
Impulse buyer.
Why?
Whatever I see I like for somebody and I purchase it.
Sometimes I make a list, sometimes not. Depends.
Is impulse shopping a little more fun?
Yeah.
I'm an impulse buyer.
Why?
I think it's more fun that way. I enjoy just going out and seeing what I can find instead of having to go from a list.
There's so much to consider being a shopping survivor, cash or credit. What you need to know about gift cards, shopping online, and refund policies. Coming up the next 2 days. Yeah, there's things about those gift cards. They've got an upside and a downside. There are things you need to know about refund policies. I'll be going into all of that for you. And also, you can go to our website, KXAN.com, and we'll have much more about wise shopping tips and how you need to manage your money and things that can protect you and save you some cash. David Scott, KXAN, Austin News.